in order to define how traffic will be steered. We have steering behaviors, which, just like a steering wheel, will steer the way based on what is set and defined within them. To view or define these behaviors, we'll go to the SD-WAN policy, Manage Behaviors. Here you'll notice we have behaviors created out of the box by Checkpoint when using the SD-WAN wizard, and custom behaviors or steerings that may be created as needed by using the new button. Here, various information can be set and defined for these purposes and done based on steering candidates and criteria. One of the main points here are the connection types, which are based on Internet or overlay VPN needs. For the Internet, there are three routing preferences, which are explained by the diagrams below them, and these will all somehow enable traffic out to the Internet. The first one is local breakout only. This enables direct access from the branch out to the Internet. The second one, backhaul only. This enables access to the Internet only from the branch via the HQ and out to the Internet. Lastly, prioritize local breakout. This enables direct access from the branch to the Internet if it is available and up, and if not, then we can make use of the path through the HQ and out to the Internet. The other option is the overlay VPN. Here, traffic will be steered going between the different sites and will not enable traffic out to the Internet, as may be seen. Now, the next parameter which we'll see are the steering candidates. Here, we basically define which of our available WAN links may be used for the decision making. We have either all relevant WAN links or specific WAN links, for which here we'll define what we'd like to have used. In the case of Internet, if there are MPLSs, they will not be available and they will not be used. Now here, we'll also notice there's the option of use the same settings for branch to HQ connection. This means that for prioritized local breakout or for backhaul only, we have the option of defining if we'd like the branch to HQ and HQ out to the Internet to be based on the same parameters for which we've defined above, as we can see if checked. This will also be available later and seen in different areas of the criteria. So that's for that. Later, we can proceed on to the criteria. In the criteria, we have three sections. We have the thresholds, WAN link utilization, and quality check methodology. In the thresholds, values should be defined as per the link quality, and these values will define when the links meet the thresholds, and when over, they perhaps should not be used. For the WAN link utilization, there are two options. Link aggregation, indicating that all valid links should be used, and the second one is prioritize, which is also divided into two. Here, we have either based on the thresholds, which are defined above, and the best link will be chosen as per the link attributes defined below, and the second option of manual order of WAN links, by which you define the order of the links and how you would like them to be, if they are both meeting the thresholds, again, defined up above. For this, you'll notice it will only be used if specific links have been defined in the steering candidates earlier, as is noted here. The last section is the quality check methodology, by which the links are actually checked for the probing usage. This may be done either using the best practice, going to 888, or a specific destination that can be defined and chosen. Currently, this is done using ping. Later options will be added. And lastly, we have the ability to define intervals of how often this check should be run. Once all is defined and saved, the different behaviors may be used in our actual SD-WAN policy. Let's go ahead and create an actual example behavior. Let's call it, for example, Internet Direct Access. Okay, in our case, we'll go ahead, let's start here, and have it be Internet and Local Breakout only. We'll use all of our relevant WAN links. For the criteria, we can go ahead and define some of the parameters, for example. So let's go ahead and set that. Let's say 30, and here perhaps 2% packet loss. We'll use the option of prioritize with the link attributes in such that it will choose the best link. And lastly, we'll remain for quality check methodology with the best practice. We'll go ahead and we'll save this, and we'll see it added to our custom steerings. Now, in our rule base, we see right now we have ones that are already defined, but if we were to go ahead and create a new rule, for example, or to switch, we could go to our plus, and we will now see the Internet Direct Access behavior or steering, which is now not active, but can also be used for the rule base that we are defining. As such, we can select the Internet Direct Access, and you'll notice now that this actually replaces the previous behavior which we had here, and this will now be the defining steering behavior, which will steer the traffic according to what we've set for this web conferencing rule. Thank you.